In this video, we take a look at how to create a church sticker like this in Photoshop. And this is coming up. Hey everybody, it's Innocent here and welcome to the channel. If you're new here, please hit on the subscribe button. If you're old here, thank you so much for showing up. A link to download the resources that I'll be using in this video will be in the description, as well as the music that I'm using in this video. Now let's get into Photoshop and let's get started. So here in the world of Photoshop, you are using Photoshop CS6 in this video, but this should work with even the latest version of Photoshop. So let's go to File and create a new document. And I'm going to create a new document like an envelope size. So at the preset here, I'll go to International Paper, and then at the size, I'll left click on it and go to the very last part, which is the DL, so the envelope DL. Now you go ahead and then you can click OK. Over here, we want to rotate this particular document, so we go to image rotation, and then you can rotate 90 clockwise or 90 anti-clockwise. Now once we have this, we can go ahead and start creating our design. So first things first, let's go into our resource, and then we have a general background that we've created. So you can drag this and drop it inside of Photoshop like that, and then you can take time to open it up to fill the entire canvas. So you double click on it when you are done. Now this looks pretty much solid, but if you want to use this one, that is just fine. But then I decided to go to filter, to blur, and then Gaussian blur to add a bit of blur to this one so that it wouldn't look that very solid. So something like this, and then you can click OK. Now we want to change the color of this background, and we're going to do that very easily. So you press Ctrl U and it activates the hue and saturation. At the first line, we have hue over there, and then you can use the slider. You can drag it to the left side or the right side, and it's going to give you a total different color. So I'm going to drag mine around this very side. So I want to get to around 140, and I want to get this particular color, and I'll click OK. So what I do is I press Ctrl T, and then I can open this up some more, something like this, and I can leave it over here. Now the next thing that we want to do is we want to bring in a subject. So I've got two pictures of the pastor and then the wife over here. So the first picture will be that of the pastor. I'll drag him and drop him over here. Now this particular picture, the background has already been taken care of. If you want to see how to do that, a link will be in the description to check that also out. And then I'll go inside of the resources, and then I have mama also here, so I'll drag and drop her inside of Photoshop, and then I'll place her somewhere around here, so something like that. Now let's quickly go to the view here and add a new guideline. So we're going to add a guideline of 50% to split the whole document into two sections. So right from there, we can know that actually we have to place this at the extreme left. So we can select the two of them, and then we can push them somewhere around here. You can take your time to, you know, work on your image. For example, at the woman's picture, you can right click and rasterize the layer, and you can press Ctrl L to add the levels to it. Open up the level a little bit like that, and then you can add a bit of hue and saturation. So you increase the saturation a little bit, the more like this. And then for the pastor's image, you can also increase the lightness or the levels a little bit like that, and you click OK. So once this is done, we are all set. We go ahead and then we can add the text to it. So inside here, I have my text written, and I'm going to use about three fonts, or let's say two fonts, excluding the 3D or the 4D fonts that I'll be using. So the first one will be the Living Christ Foundation Church. I'll copy that, and on top here, I'll go for my text tool, left click, and then I can paste it right over here. So I'll go and change this particular one to medium, or let me just go for semi-bold like that, and I'll press Ctrl A and center it like this. Now before I forget, I left one of the backgrounds here, so let's quickly add it and then we can proceed. So when you go to the resources, we have this pouring oil background here, so let's drag and drop it inside of Photoshop, and then we want to place it somewhere around here. You want to kind of transform it to make it a bit smaller, something like that. I use this particular same background during the All Night flyer. You can check that up over here. So you right click and then you can rasterize that one. You press Control Shift and then U to desaturate it, and then you can set this particular one to overlay, or you can try soft light. Either of them that works best for you. So I personally think that soft light works the best for us. So what we're going to do next is we're going to add a layer mask to it. Choose your brush tool and make sure that your foreground is black. This is very important. I have a lot of complaints that the layer mask is not working. You will check and then you figure out that the foreground color is red. If it happens that way, it is not working for you. So when the foreground color is black, you just go ahead and then you can brush this one off. You can brush it off from here and that, and it smoothly blends with the other background. And from there, we can go back to our test and we can proceed. So back to the test, we right click and go to the blending options, and we're going to add a bit of drop shadow to it. So you click on the drop shadow and then you can increase the drop shadow a little bit and you click OK. Now it's time to add the main title, and to add the main title, it says that declaration 2020. So I have in here the declaration already. So I'll go for my test tool and I'm going to type declaration. So over here, I'm going to type declaration. So something like that. And I'm going to use the font Aston Script. This is the particular font, and I'm going to open it up to be a little bit bigger like that. So declaration, and then for the 2020, let me just zoom in here, and then for the 2020, I got this particular 3D or 4D, I don't really know whether it's a 3D or 4D test or image or PNG from the internet. I should make this clear that I didn't do this, I got it from the internet. All right, reserved to the creative who did this amazing thing. I'll leave a link in the description in case you want to download this and use it. So I'm going to transform it out to be a bit smaller like this one. So it says declaration 2021. So something pretty simple like that. This 3D or 4D is so beautiful. The one who did this is amazing. He's a genius. The next thing we want to do is to add effects to this particular 3D test or 4D test, and you right click and go to rasterize, right click on the same layer, go to the blending options, and then you can add an auto glow to it. So at the auto glow section, we're going to pick a very deep color from here, so something like this one or over here, and you click OK. You can increase the size a little bit like that so that it glows, and then you can increase the spread also a little bit, just a little like that, and from there you're good to go. You can go ahead and then click OK, and that is the only effect that you're going to add to this particular 2020. The next set of tests that you're going to add will be this declaration, so the actual declaration over here. So we're going to copy the whole of this one, and then we're going to choose our test tool, and we can make the test over here and we can paste it. So I'm going back to my font Poppins, so let's go and select Poppins from here, and then this is going to be medium or regular, either of them, but let's change the color to white, something like that, and let's click OK from here, and we can press Ctrl T to transform it out to be something like this, and we can place it over here. So declaration 2021, and then the test comes over here. Under the test, let's try to add this particular rectangle here, so something like that, and make sure that the color is black, and you can decrease the opacity to around 20%. So you can either use the opacity here, you slide it to the left side, or you can use your numeric keys, and then when you type any single number, it is going to decrease it to that opacity. Now the last thing that we add is we make a duplicate of this test, and then we can bring it over here. We go into the test, and then we have the name of the pastor and the wife. Now the last things that we're going to add will be the effect that we apply on this particular whole sticker, and then we are going to apply that effect on this Golden 2021 test effect. So inside of the resources, we have this lens flare. We drag and drop it inside of Photoshop, and then we can place it somewhere around this side. Now you can double click on it, go to the blending mode, left click on it and change this particular one to screen. So all the blacks will be gone and then it will be left with only the lighting part of it. Let's right click on this, rasterize the layer, go to filter and go to blur, Gaussian blur, and then you can change this particular one like that and you can bring it somewhere over here. So it works pretty simple like that. You can open it up, the more you open it up the brighter it becomes. And just like we did for the background, we're going to try to alter this color a little bit because it looks so brightening over there. So you press on Control U and then it is going to activate the hue and saturation, and you can slide it to the very left side. I think 15, 16 or 18. This particular color worked pretty well for me and I go ahead and I click OK. So I can press Control J to make another duplicate, which is going to brighten it the more. And then you can see from here that the 2021 here looks quite fading out when we added the light. So we go back to that particular layer and then we can press Control L and then we're going to decrease, or we're going to add a bit of levels to it so that it can sort of blend in with the color that we added over there. And from there we can go back to the lens flare over here, make a duplicate, and then we can drag it to the extreme left side over here. We want to place it at where the pasta is. We can press Control T and we can transform it to be a little bit smaller like that. But for that one, let's go back to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and then we can blur it out some more. We don't want it to look so very solid, so something like that. And finally you can make some few changes to the main background, so you can add a bit of levels to it to make it quite darker so that it blends in with the actual background that we have over here. And there, if there is any other thing that you want to add, for instance over here we have the logo, you can as well drag and drop it inside of Photoshop and then you add it. Or if there is any text that you want to further add, you can actually drop it. So like I was saying, for the rectangle you can actually increase it up a little bit like this so that it can be very well seen. And that wraps it up for this video. That is how to create a very simple but nice looking church sticker for your church. You can use the same approach, the same backgrounds and everything to do the same thing for your church. Or if you're a pastor yourself, you can design this for yourself. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, please hit on the subscribe button, like and share this video, and check out the other videos that I've made so far. We have a ton of videos that you can check on the channel. Thank you so much for sticking around to watch. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. It's Innocent here, and bye.